Hello everybody, it's Jeremy here, bringing you another video log. Today is April 22nd, 2011, and I am killing steel dragons. Last weekend, I ended off my video log by saying I was going to a outdoorsman retreat, and I did, and it was very enjoyable, so thanks for asking, even though none of you did. So, this week I've been kind of doing a lot of training and spending a lot of money, and so I ended up selling my DFS and my tacits. I know I made my video log about buying them and that I was never going to sell them, but I did, and I have good reasons. I got a special level that I've been wanting to get for a while now, and that happened to be 80 summoning. I finally got the charms for it, and I got that level yesterday, so I'm pretty excited about that. I also got 77 Slayer, which I just got right now, so that's pretty cool. I do have these as my task, and I'm in Kurdel's dungeon right now. I can now slay desert strike worms. You can expect a guide on that as soon as I get it as a task, so yeah, I need that to accompany my jungle strike worm guide. But I just got that, and I got 90 magic. I have everything I need for 94 magic, so I'm gonna be getting that this week. And I just got 74 prayer last night. I had enough infernal ashes from my black demon task to get it, so I just went ahead and did it at the Ectofuntis. And getting closer to 85 attack, I'll get that in the next day or so. And also, I'll probably get 85 defense by the end of the week. I also got 55 dungeoneering. I was 49 before, I think. Hoping to get that to 60 by the end of the weekend. And yeah, so that's pretty much all of the stat updates that I've gotten. I got 91 HP. I don't know if I had that or not, but I got it. And yeah, so that's my stats, and this is my loot so far. Gotta build up my charms again. So I sold my DFS and tacits to pay for magic and summoning. I still have like 24 mil in cash, so I could technically buy my tacits back, but I really don't think I'm going to at this point, because I really don't need it. It's just really expensive, and my Varex skirt has better defense bonus, so I'm going to sacrifice the strength bonus for that and have a lot of money that I can spend on stuff. But, yeah, so I'm kind of switching gears and working on getting 85 dungeoneering rather than getting 99 strength first, mostly because if I get 85 dungeoneering, I can get 99 strength while I kill frost dragons, and I'll get a lot more money doing that than killing blue dragons. So I'm going to do that instead, because I'll be able to get my 95 prayer a lot faster. So that's that plan. And so today is Good Friday, and Sunday is Easter. And today I actually just got back from our Good Friday service at my church, and I played John, the disciple, in our skit play thing, whatever you want to call it. And I didn't find out that I was going to be playing John until last night, about 15 minutes before they were going to practice. So yeah, it was kind of a last minute thing, and I think it went well. I didn't have too many lines, so it didn't matter. What is up with these ones? There, that's right, 214, that's better. 38, come on, seriously? 90 magic should be doing better. But yeah, so I was in that play, and that was interesting. I was wearing my Chucks, my Chuck Taylors, and I forgot to take them off when I went up to do my part. And as I was walking up to the front of the sanctuary, I was like, "Crap!" I realized that I had them on, so I was like slipping them off as I was walking. And thankfully, I'm smooth enough that no one noticed. So that was kind of funny. But yeah. So I don't know what my guide's gonna be on for Monday, but if I get that Desert Strikeworm task, I'll definitely be making it on that. But other than that, leave some comments on some ideas that you would like for guides. I do have some ideas and some suggestions that people gave me before, but I don't think I'm going to be making them because I'm holding off on making any more 99 skill guides until I have the 99s in that skill. Mostly because it's not worth taking the criticism for not having a 99 and making a 99 guide. I'd much rather have the skill and then give you the advice, because I did get some flack for not having 99 hunter and making a hunter guide. I believe it was the hunter guide, but yeah. So that's kind of going to be what I'm going to be doing from now on, is not making 99 guides until I have the 99. So if you guys have any suggestions on guides, or if you actually do want me to still make 99 guides and just ignore the trolls, I can do that for sure. But I think if I do make skill guides, it'll be "This is how I train it," not a "This is how you can train it to 99. I'll probably do that. What I'm doing to get 94 magic is I'm high elking and doing odd slayer tasks with magic. I think that's the easiest way to get it, and I'm really looking forward to having vengeance, because it'll help me out so much with PKing, and I don't know, but I am definitely not PKing until I have 95 prayer. I'll PK if I have 95 prayer and not 99 strength, but I definitely have to have 95 prayer before I will go PKing, because it's not fair. It's totally not fair. Everyone my level has turmoil. Everyone. Even people below my level have turmoil. So it's just cheap. Because they can just rape me, and I can't do anything. And people that have, like, soul split, they're like, "I'm gonna use it because I spent 95, or I spent 150 mil on it, so I'm gonna use it. I don't care if you don't want to fight me with it." And then they rape me. And then I lose all my stuff. So that's not cool. But if you have suggestions for videos, like I said, just leave a comment or send me a message, and I'll try to make them. Also, leave a comment saying what you would like me to make videos on for Wednesdays, because I got some feedback from you guys, from Andy, and he wants me to make some videos on Wednesdays, but he doesn't really know what he wants me to make. So if you guys could help me and him out with some ideas of what you would like to see from me, go ahead and leave a comment. I do enjoy making videos, and if you guys want to see more videos from me more often, I will definitely make them. I enjoy this. I enjoy the interaction with my viewers. I definitely enjoy talking with some of you guys in my CC. I better pay attention to that, but yeah, so I don't think I want to talk about anything else. I mean, the new item items kept on death update that Jagex just released. That is bringing it's a hot topic right now. I know people are, some people like it, some people hate it. I know a lot of PKers that are serious PKers hate it, mostly because everyone has a Karasi now in the wild. If they have it, they're using it. I see a lot of people doing like Godsword to Karasi, or Whip to Karasi, or just anything to Karasi. It's just totally unfair. Whereas before, if someone was doing Whip to Karasi, you wouldn't really care because they are risking the Whip. Now they don't risk the Whip, they risk the Karasi. I'm guilty myself of doing a little Whip to Karasi. I just had to try it out, and I did, and I got a few kills, but I also died several times. And I guess my only comment to that is, you know, even though they're risking a lot less than before, it's still, you're still going to get like a 400k PK off of someone if they die with Karasi, because the Karasi drops 245k gold pieces when it's killed, or, you know, when it's dropped. So, you know, it's still pretty decent PK. And people are definitely risking more than they were before, because, like, I know personally, when I would go PKing, I would only risk, like, 150 to 200k. Now if I go Whip to Karasi, I'm risking closer to 500k because of the Karasi. But, yeah, so I guess you just have to kind of learn to play around that. I mean, I'm definitely looking forward to how it works dying outside of the wilderness. If you die in the wilderness, the items that you keep are based on their GE price at the time. So, like, pretty much everyone's going to be keeping their high item priced stuff. Like, AGS is pretty much always going to be kept. Divine is always going to be kept. Stuff like that's always going to be kept. I was watching a video of a guy PKing with a red Halloween mask. And, I mean, come on. Before, that would have been dropped if, you know, it would have been risked if he would have gone, but not since he, since the update, it was kept. I mean, he didn't die with it because he's an epic PKer. His name is Bonesaw PK, if anyone knows about him or would like to look him up. But, you know, he just went after it, and, it was crazy. It's like, I wouldn't even risk taking that in, because, you know, what if you run out of prayer and then you die, and, you know, you just lost, you know, a couple hundred mil, or however much it is now. And yeah, so this is going a little longer than I expected, but I hope you guys liked it. I know some people like video logs to be a little longer. I know personally I enjoy listening to longer video logs. It's kind of nice to be able to play RuneScape and listen to someone talk at the same time. It's just, it's easy to do and fun to keep tabs on, you know, what everyone's up to in the game and how their week went and just their thoughts on new updates and stuff. Silent Core just released episode 2 of his RuneCast, where it's him and a panel of 3 other people, I think, and they just talk about RuneScape stuff, and I thought that was pretty cool. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, rate, comment, and subscribe. Thumbs up the video is what I mean by rate. And if you didn't like it, go ahead and give it a thumbs down and leave a comment telling me what you didn't like and how I can improve in my future videos. I definitely accept constructive criticism, and I guess I'm going to leave the video on a couple of screenshots of one of my subscribers donating to me. It's Andy Rars. He's pretty cool. He donated 1.6 mil and a brackish blade, which I sold for 1.3 mil. So he donated 2.9 mil basically. And that was very generous of him. And I appreciate it very much, man. So, I just want to let you guys know, if you do donate to me, you will be featured in this, in a video. And, if you have a YouTube channel that you would like to be, you know, if you'd like a shout out or whatever, just let me know and I'll put it in there. Even if you want a shout out and you don't donate, just let me know and I'll put you in a, I'll feature you in a video. I like to help you guys out as much as you help me out. There's only one way for us to get our names out there, and that's by helping each other spread the word. So, as always, have a nice weekend, and, yeah, we'll see you on Monday for another guide. Peace.